Good morning, everybody. Welcome behind the scenes here at Jamie Ridler Studios. I am Jamie, and it is Wednesday. I had a wonderful Halloween with my sister Shannon, my husband Justin. We carved a beautiful pumpkin. We toasted pumpkin seeds. We had a wonderful feast, and we watched movies. And this is our tradition. We've been doing this for years, like since Justin and I first started dating. So this week has already been off to an amazing start for our journal lab, which used to be called Journal Sampler, but the name Journal Lab kept coming up, and it just captures the spirit of experimentation and exploration that we are doing in that class. So we had our first Journal Lab glue party, because we're doing glue books this week. And it was so much fun. We played with all different things from speed and tearing to thoughtful reflection, and had a great conversation too. So thank you to my journal labbers for showing up and being a part of the party, especially since it was such a spontaneous decision to do that. This morning, I have been thinking about the nature of success. More specifically, I've been thinking on the clients I've worked with over a decade now. I've been working with people to, you know, create a life they're wild about. And most usually that has to do with bringing more of their creativity into their life. And it also often means entrepreneurial pursuits. So I was thinking about, what do I notice about their success? What do I notice is a constant or a theme, or where I see people really stepping into what they want and receiving what they hope for? And one of the things I noticed right away when I was thinking about it is rarely, though not never, but rarely ever dramatic. You know, it's rarely something suddenly drops into your lap, or suddenly you make one decision and everything bursts open. Though certainly we experience, and I've seen this with my clients, I experience with myself, that kind of instantaneous flow when things come together beautifully and suddenly, whoosh, you move together like you're playing snakes and ladders, and suddenly you went whoosh to the next place. That happens. But I mean, somebody doesn't just apply for that one job or launch that one product and suddenly they've made it. That doesn't seem to be the case. So then if it's not like that, a sort of instantaneous dream come true, a lottery ticket, a great decision, a miracle launch, someone being discovered, then what is it? So I've been thinking about that. So one of the first things I noticed that is essential really at the beginning is belief. A belief that something other than what is possible. It doesn't even have to be a big belief that I will be leading retreats in Bali in 2019 on the power of the three books I've written between now and then. You know, a lot of people recommend being that specific. But it really starts with something much smaller. If we say those things, but we have no belief that we can ever leave our day job, we have no belief that we'll ever be published, we have no belief that we can build an audience, we have no belief that we can risk giving up the security of what we have, then I think we stay put with those dreams showing up over and over and over again with not much progress. So I think that first step is crucial, this believing that something, it doesn't even have to be the big dream, but believing that something other than what is right now is possible. Another component that's crucial is a willingness to risk. A willingness to upset the apple cart, a willingness to try something that may not work, a willingness to lose, to fail, to make mistakes, to be embarrassed, a willingness to risk loss in order to achieve that sense of not necessarily gain, certainly the possibility for gain, but also that sense of self-confidence that comes with acting on that belief in possibility. I think there is something that we grow, a muscle that gets stronger when we don't give up hope, but instead we give it a shot. I think we feel proud of ourselves. We have only limited control over how the world responds to what we do, but we generally feel stronger, more self-confident, proud, brave, when we take a step, when we try something, when we risk stepping into what might be possible. And I guess that's the other piece too. I think that feeling of success and moving towards what you love, what you dream of, or something that is better for you, even if you don't know what it is, always involves bravery. Always. And it may not look like huge bravery to anybody else. Nobody can tell you what is brave and what is not. You get to define what's brave, and only you know when you are truly heroic. I'll never forget in my coaching training, you know, somebody would set somebody homework and they'd say, okay, by the end of this week, I want you to talk to 50 people about your new business. And she was like, sure, no problem. She was an extrovert and she knew she was going to a conference and it was no big deal. It was not hard for her at all to talk to 50 people, though for other people, they would be like cringing with the effort. But then the question came up, okay, tomorrow night, I want you to talk to your mom about what you're doing. That's where her bravery was needed. So this is a very personal thing. So believing in possibility, a willingness to risk, and a willingness to be brave. One of the other pieces is a straight up one that is incredibly undervalued, especially in our exciting online world. Effort. Doing the work, showing up, being consistent, learning your craft, so that if you really want to be published, you need to write. If you want to sell your paintings, you need to paint. If you want people to know about what you do, you have to consistently share. You have to do the work. So what I see in my clients is week after week after week after week, taking sometimes big steps, sometimes small steps, but always sometimes backward steps and then forward steps, but always, always moving forward, always expending the effort, doing the work of moving into what you want to do. I think that finding a way that you can honor the work, love the work, nourish yourself as you show up for the work, find the value and meaning in the work, the easier it is to come to this particular step. And then a little extra piece, and this is really a part of doing the work, but especially for those people who are interested and excited about entrepreneurial pursuits. The core piece is having an offer and being willing to ask. And this can apply to lots and lots of things, but where I show it up the most is in the entrepreneurial world. So we are willing to build our blog. We're willing to build our following. We're willing to develop our brand, our website. And yet we don't yet have, like, well, what is that thing that people can pay me for? What is that thing that I actually am offering to the world, and am I willing to offer it in exchange for money? This seems to be a real sticking point. Before you have built your website, before you have designed your signature program, somebody in front of you may need help, and you can say, hey, do you know that I actually help people declutter their closets, and it costs blah, blah, blah per day I would love to support you with that. Right? You don't have to wait for all the accoutrements to be in place in order to be of service, to offer and to ask. And then lastly, and this kind of comes full circle to this idea of believing in what's possible, is a willingness to change. If you are being consistent with your effort, if you notice things are not working, if you have been brave and said yes and tried new things, then to shift something. For me, this is the same mind as the belief that something else is possible. Because we can be on a road, and I'm not talking, this is not the same thing as, do I stay on this road or do I give up my entire dream, my goal, my vision of success? Not at all. This is about changing tactics, strategy, and adjusting direction. So that if you are doing something and you're doing it consistently and it just doesn't seem, you're not seeing that flow pick up, you're not seeing that energy, you're feeling heavy and tired, but not in that like good at the end of the day, I've worked so hard, let me just like have a shower and sit down and feel proud of myself, but instead like I feel like I'm churning. I feel like the wheel is spinning. Change something. A willingness to believe that something can be different. A willingness to risk and be brave. Maybe this is not the course. It doesn't mean you're not a teacher. Maybe this is not the right magazine for you. Maybe this is not the right publisher for you. It doesn't mean you're not a writer. So those are some of the things that I notice as I work with my clients about what helps really powerfully move them forward. Generally not big drama, but a willingness to believe that change is possible, that something good, better, wonderful is right through that door. A willingness to risk opening that door, even if it upsets the apple cart. The bravery to do that. The willingness to show up and do the work. And that includes a willingness to offer and to ask. And I just feel like I want to make a little side note about that. That doesn't have to be entrepreneurial. Just think about how that may play out in your relationships. Sometimes we are aching for things to be different, but we're not willing to ask. Why? Because we don't want to upset the apple cart. So see, these things are all intertwined and can really apply to your work, your life, your creativity. And then lastly, if things are not working, be willing to risk changing. So that's what I'm thinking about here in the studio today as I prepare for this weekend. I'm doing a workshop with a group of people who have experienced the loss of a family member about how journaling can help them find their way through. So I am deep in preparation for that, deep in working on the Fibonacci lesson for those of you who are in the journal lab, and then also journal club on Friday, which is always just the best way to finish off the week. So busy, short week here in the studio. Lots of good stuff. I hope there's lots of good stuff going on in your studio. Remember, your life is your studio. I'll see you on Friday.